Right, it's Brady, I'm going to give you a mathematical gift. I mean, I'll give you many mathematical gifts. I'm going to give you a very special one today. And now, to make it extra special, I often ask people when I do this, it's one of my party tricks, their age. But that feels a little impersonal. So would you want to give me an arbitrary number between 21 and 65? What would you like?
42.
42! Ah, nerd. Okay, right, so 42. That gets smaller. Two. All right, there's more. I'm starting with those digits. I'm going to put a 5 in over there. I'm going to put a 3. Actually, I'm going to put a 3 there and a 6 there. I'm allowed to change it as I go. That's going to be a 9. That's going to be a 10. A 2, 23, 24, and 12. And what I've done for you there, if you double check, all the numbers in the top row will add up to 42, if you go through and check those. The second row will add up to 42, and all the columns up to 42, the diagonals are 42, the opposite, I mean, all four in the corners up to 42, each four in the corner adds, it's a magic square. I love magic squares, mathematicians love these a lot. And so there, that for you, Brady, that is a gift magic square based on the number 42.
Now make one for 58.
Look at him think. 50. Okay, let's do another one for 58. This one's going to be wildly different at 58. So I'm going to put a 5 there. I'm going to put a 4 there. I'm going to put a 3 there. I'm going to put a 6 there. I'm going to put a 1 there, 8. And then that one's 38. And then 39. And then 40. And there you are. An incredible amount of mental arithmetic later. I have managed to... You look unimpressed. I'm going to be honest.
The first time I was impressed. Now I think maybe you're just using a pro forma and slightly...
Maybe all I'm doing is if you gave me the number N, then I'm going through and I'm doing these are all exactly the same every single time. And so I fill in those. And these are easy to remember. These are the multiples of 9, 54, 36, 18, 72. Then I remember I put 9 down there, 10, 11, 12. And then I do n minus 21, I do n minus 20, I do n minus 19, and I do n minus 18, and that is a magic square. The problem, of course, and the reason it gets a bit suspicious with big numbers, is you can look at this one here and you go, wait, they're all quite small, and then what's this? There's like suddenly some massive 30s and 40s going on. You'd be a little bit unimpressed. So even though you gave me 58 out of nowhere, you look at this and be a little bit suspicious. So
that's why ages are often good.
Ages are often good because they tend to be in around the 30s and 40s is perfect. Anything too big starts to go awry.
What if they give you like 8?
Actually, that's why I said between 21. So ages are very good because then this one, if someone says 21, you have a 0 there, which I'm kind of okay with. I don't mind zeros. It goes 0, 1, 2, 3. Anything smaller, you get negative numbers. So the square still works if you gave me a tiny number. So if you gave me something like 8, then I would have in that spot there, I'd have to subtract 21 off 8 and I'd have a negative 13 hanging out in there.
And if I gave you a million?
And if you give me a million, you have massive, massive numbers.
Or this diagonal, or that diagonal, they add up, or this little square in here, they all add up to the same number, which is 176. If I now turn it upside down...
Magic hexagon, if it exists, has to be of size 3.
I don't want to call it the Parker square because it doesn't work properly. Everybody will be like, oh, that's a classic Parker square.